Hello and welcome to our podcast. I am Risa.
And I'm Ariana.
And we're the Crawlmeister Sisters. As a reminder, this podcast is rated T for teen or strong language and whatever else we feel like talking about in the day.
Is it gonna be drinking? Is it gonna be sex? Who knows?
Who knows? Maybe it's just going to be adult themes.
Yeah, like sadness.
Sadness, maybe.
Like adult sadness.
Adult sadness, which is different than children sadness.
It is. Actually, it's definitely different. It's a little different. We get sad about the weirdest things. If you don't want adult sadness in your podcast about Nancy Drew, if you just want to enjoy Nancy Drew, maybe some behind-the-scenes stuff, then check out her very own podcast on YouTube, Unlocked.
It's also on iTunes.
Yeah. On iTunes, whatever, dibba. Wherever you can find podcasts, it's possibly there.
Possibly.
Possibly.
Possibly. So, sister, what are we talking about today?
Today, we are going to get in a time machine and inexplicably transport the entire cast of Nancy Drew into the 1930s.
For some reason.
And discover a secret about an old clock or something like that.
Yes. Or many old clocks, who knows?
Many old clocks.
I mean, really.
Yeah.
So yes, we're talking about the secret of the old clocks. There's at least two clocks. At least. So yes, we're going to talk about Secret of the Old Clock. Secret of the Old Clock, if you haven't played it, takes place in 1930 for literally no reason. I've ranted about this before.
Because this is not like this.
It has bugged me. Like, it first came out, and I was, like, kind of excited, but then we were there, and there was no, like, explanation, and it was just, like, and then the next thing that came out, we went, and in the scrapbook, it's, like, it's 1930. It's, like...
But why is it 1930? Why was it 1930, Nancy?
And Nancy was aware that it was 1930. And she scrapbooks about it being far from her telephone or something like that. And I'm like,
yeah.
Why? So, we played this game. This is the first game we ever played current. So, we had waited for it. Like, this was exciting.
Like, we didn't have to wait, I don't know, like, two and a half years.
Yeah, no.
But, we certainly waited for it.
We did. We waited a whole, like, 3 months.
Yeah.
So, it was completely, you know, there's a word I'm looking for, but I can't think of it.
We were getting, like, it was very anticipatory wait.
Yes,
you know,
it was.
We were getting all amped up because we were like, A,
Blackmore Manor was
caught
awesome.
Up, and then... Yeah, and then B, Secret of the Old Clock. We read that.
Yes.
I mean, if you've read Nancy Drew, odds are you've at least read Secret of the Old Clock.
Mm-hmm.
That's just, you know, required reading.
Yeah.
So we're like, yeah! Excited.
Isn't that the one where we have the first edition copy back at the parents' house?
I believe we do.
That one. It's like a literally first printing.
Yeah. We book sale was good to us.
Yeah,
got a lot of
ridiculous books.
Mm-hmm.
So, what do we like about this game? You go.
Despite everything, it's just genuinely kind of fun. It's nice. It's jaunty.
I do. I love that because it generally just feels like a good game.
Mm-hmm.
Like, despite the fact that there's a lot of issues with it, which we go on to talk about.
Oh, don't worry. We will not skimp on the cons of this list.
But it's still just a really, like, you start playing it, and it's fun. And the way that you can go around, and the setting is just really cool. And I love the inn. I love the design of it all.
I do love the inn and all the area around it, like into all the property.
Yes,
so good.
Definitely. It's a really nice just location, definitely.
The costuming is fun.
It is fun, yeah.
Not at all times, you know, 100% on. But it then comes the costumers and us. But no, it's still fun. It's nice and colorful, but also, you know, keeping with the era of, well, the nation just took a turn.
Yeah, pretty much. Also, as I said in our notes, I'm always a slut for clock puzzles.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, it's true. We love us some good clock puzzles.
It's true.
We love us some good clocks, just
clocks in general.
Yeah.
Weird. Yeah. I don't know.
I don't know what it is. I don't know. I blame our grandfather for that.
Pretty much. Yeah. Also, the music is super fun.
Oh my god, I love the music so much. Like,
it's really nice and.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Jaunty is really the best word for me to describe it.
Yeah.
It's you know, it's all very high energy. It's just bouncy. And just, yeah, it's all what you expect the banker's walk to be like. Did you not expect him to kind of bounce a little bit while it, bloop, 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 bloop? I don't know. That's what I expect from him, I guess. I guess maybe it's just me.
Okay, so what don't we like about it? Other than, why is she in 1930? Why did we do this? Why did they do it?
Why is this happening to us?
It's like, they said it in 1930. I think we've talked about this before. Mm-hmm. They said it in 1930, but then, and they're like, oh, let's add references in this newspaper about 1930. And it's like from stuff that have nothing to do with, like, it's like supposed to take place in like February or something. And they mention things from like June and a movie
that came out in like
November. It's just like,
Hey, remember this thing? This hadn't happened yet.
If you're going to put references in, at least make sure that they're accurate. But I just don't like inaccurate stuff, because that's who
Nor
I am.
Do I. As somebody who, you know, would like her history to be, you know, straightforward and historical.
Generally.
Like, if you're going to throw it in there, throw it in correctly.
Yeah. Also,
they could have easily had it take place in, like, the fall, and then all that stuff could have happened.
I know, right?
You know, it's not difficult. That place would have been beautiful in the fall.
Yeah.
Oh, the leaves blowing around.
Yeah. That reminds me, it's already like off topic. It's just August here. It's August. And for some reason, half of the trees have decided they're going to start turning colors already. And I'm like, you stop that.
Stop that.
It is not fall yet. Stop it. Also, everyone in this game sounds like they're in a weird movie.
Like Joan Cusack.
Like Joan Cusack. Because that's, like, come on. Is Jane not Joan Cusack? Like, they had to have modeled it after her, right? It's like, obviously, I feel like that her interactive will grab random pictures to model characters after. And
cough, Victor from Deadly Device.
Yes. He looks just like fucking Jeff Bridges.
Like Jeff Bridges.
And Iron Man. I'm just like, are you kidding me? So this is another one of those where it looks like they just literally were like, it would fit this part. I'd cast Joan Cusack. Let's just, you know, trace over her face.
Right.
I don't know.
It's weird. But yeah, she talks funny.
She does.
Yeah, I think was our main point of bringing up Jane already was just she talks weird. She talks. She don't tie no good.
They all have some weird things about them, but hers is the worst.
She primarily speaks in
quips.
She speaks in quips, and she speaks in look at what era I'm in.
Bad slang.
Like, yeah, she just, like, colloquialisms. There you go. That's what I was looking for. Colloquialism.
Yeah, exactly. Colloquialisms.
Those things.
Pretty much.
But, Yeah, so she just sort of speaks. She's like, remember, we're in 1930. Aces.
I know. And it doesn't make sense.
Just shut up. Shut up. Speak like a human. Please. I know humans spoke normally in the 1930s.
Probably. They probably spoke normal.
I mean, there were those people that were the equivalent of people these days who speak in internet speak, and you're like, wait, stop. Speak human for a second. And those people had to be floating about, and Jane is apparently the embodiment of them. Although she's too old to be doing it.
It's true. Well, she was trying to pretend she was someone else. At least there's that.
It doesn't matter.
Maybe that was part of it. Maybe she was just so trying to be someone else that she just didn't know.
She put together this ridiculous backstory for Jane. She was like, yeah, she's really hip. She's good. She's up with the times. You know, let's go study what the kids are saying these days.
Okay. So who's
people
our...
talk funny.
Yes. Who's our favorite character?
I'm going to have to say the cows in the middle of the road.
The cows in the middle of the road that we almost hit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Almost.
I mean, I guess you hit them.
Occasionally, Ariana gets tired of this shit and slams into them, even though she knows that they're not going anywhere.
They're not going anywhere, and you're just going to harm your tires.
You're just going to harm... I don't care.
I'm just going to have to go...
I'm glad. Carson shouldn't have let his...
Deliver more fucking telegrams so that we can buy a new tire.
Mean old man... Sorry. The fucking...
Oh, God, I hate this. Okay, that's for later.
On favorite characters. Favorite characters. What's your favorite character, sister?
The cat.
We like animals. I feel like when we can't really find many things that we like about things, we find the animal.
I like the cat because it's like the people at Her Interactive had never seen the cat before and decided to model one off of description. Right,
this is what
though?
Cat is, yes.
What does this cat want? That's the other thing. That's my favorite line in all of the Nancy Drew games. And I use it pretty often, especially when my cat starts yelling at me. I go, what does this cat want? I really identify with Yuri the cat because I too scream until someone gives me what I like.
Basically.
You know, please just give me my toy. I'm just going to yell at you until you give me my toy. That's the most realistic cat in any game.
Just give me what I want or I'm going to continue screaming at you. And even then, I might still continue screaming at you.
Pretty much.
Oh, this is what I wanted, but you didn't get it to me fast enough, so... but okay, let's talk people. There's a people we find interesting, and I feel like that's only because we don't actually have to deal with him.
Very true. Josiah Grass. Probably. The dead guy. Because we walk in there to comfort our kind of friend about her dead mother, and then immediately go, oh man, you have another dead person? Let me ask you about that.
Crap. I hit the Nancy Drew jackpot. Two dead people to bluntly talk about. I know. Yes!
It's like this poor girl. And then Nancy's like, hey, about your dead neighbor.
We were very close to him. Why are you doing this to me, Nancy?
So, Josiah Crowley, let's just talk about him.
Let's talk about Josiah Crowley.
Josiah Crowley did so many things for the drama of it all.
Much.
He dressed in drag. Went to Jim Archer's birthday party. But he obviously dressed in drag many times because this is someone...
Clearly did it instantly.
Yeah, yeah. He had a fake psychic around, which, let's be real, he probably knew he was fake and just loved for the drama of it all.
Yeah, this was an intelligent man who, like, created... He had the presence of mind to, like... put together all these puzzles and do this horrible shit. So he clearly knew that this was a fake psychic he was just keeping around for fun.
No, seriously. Probably like some, you know, kind of a sugar baby type thing as well.
Yeah, it could have been that.
A little bit.
Little sugar daddy situation.
But also, he, okay, he kept a ham radio to talk in code to people. And he trained these, he would just talk to them.
He trained them like SEALs. They are trained SEALs.
And if someone says this quote to you, what do you say back?
Like, and what do you do? What do you do?
And it's like these people all like loved him so much and enjoyed him so much that they just went along with it. It's the best part to me.
Yeah. But he's like the doctor. He just wants to see what he can get people to do. How far can I push humanity?
Pretty much. Oh man, now I have a crackpot theory for later.
Oh, I have a couple of crackpot theories for later. I came up with them while we were making our notes. I was like, ho damn.
So also, this isn't even the end of it. He does all this shit. He puts like secret fucking messages in trivets and who the fuck does that?
Trivet,
he creates that whole fucking like mirror system thing. He made his own miniature golf course. Like what the fuck, man?
Time and money.
Yes.
Like this
and,
man.
Yeah. And he decided it would be too sensible to actually just have his will ready, and instead decided he needed to fucking hide it. Because he was apparently the kind of man who thought, well, if you don't work for it, you don't deserve it.
And that is the person we aspire to be.
Yep.
If my kids didn't work for it, they don't deserve my money.
Yep. They have to earn their inheritance. It'll be like 2 pennies and a moth flying out of a wallet, but...
God damn it, they'll earn it.
They will earn that moth wallet.
Because the fact that the moth has stayed alive long enough for them to solve these puzzles is a miracle. It's a miracle moth.
It's true.
I'm sorry. I went off on a tangent. Point is, parents thought people wouldn't be upset enough about his... Like, wouldn't she think that this... Do you think that he thought, okay, here I'm leaving them puzzles, this will let them enjoy themselves while they're grieving me? Or did he just think people weren't going to miss him and this wasn't going to bring up, like, sadness? Like, because, I'm sorry, somebody does this to me. It's like, why? I just want closure. You're dragging this on and on and on. Like, just let, give them closure. Let it end.
Yeah. I don't know.
No matter what, you cannot say he was not an interesting man.
Very true. So who is our least favorite character?
I mean, I don't know that any of the characters are really strong enough for me to dislike.
That's kind of a bad thing about this, is that all of the characters are super, like, nondescript in a way. Like,
yeah.
Some of them completely, like, physically as well, other than Joan Cusack. So yeah. I want to say I don't like Jane, but, like, one, there's not enough of her to not like.
Other than the fact that she's clearly the bad guy from the get-go.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Like, and then again, also, how can I stay mad at 1930s Joan Cusack?
How can you stay mad at 1930s Joan Cusack, ever?
Yeah.
I know Emily drives me a little crazy, just because, I don't know, she's just so... She's like a worse version of, oh my god, what's her name, in Carousel.
Joy?
Yes, she's a bit like Joy in that she's that, like, whiny, very, like, I don't know, it's something about her just being all...
She's wishy-washy, like, okay, yes, and she's just kind of...
And just, like...
To be fair...
Just being, she's just, like, she's a plastic bag in the wind that's, like, crying about blowing around in the wind. I don't know how to... I mean,
to be fair, the character just suffered 2 great losses. However, yeah. I don't think that's really a character thing that you're talking about. It's more like... They designed her badly and gave her a bad script, so...
Exactly. So that's why I don't exactly hold it against her.
As opposed to Joy, which is just, you know, a bad character. Ooh. Like, I just do not like
that character. We haven't done Carousel yet, right?
We have not.
Okay, that's going to be really fun. I'm going to really tear into Joy, guys.
We've known too many. So much. We've known too many Joys in our life.
Literally.
That's the issue. Well, yes. True. One, yep. But, yeah, I feel like Emily is just written two-dimensionally. Mm-hmm. And it's just, like, really
They all are, I guess, is the problem. Yeah. And they're all very two-dimensional. Oh, I am the, apparently I'm doing the psychic voice. So
yeah,
I'm gonna
I noticed.
I was actually trying to go into Jim Archer, but I'm going to apparently go into
Really funny.
Name?
Richard Topham.
Yes, thank you. I was like, toppy, top, top, two.
Really funny is that I keep forgetting Jim Archer's name. And I was doing that quiz that someone put together. Where you have to put the names in. And I was getting to him, and I was just like, Jeff? No. I'm thinking
That's
Jeff
so
Akers.
Funny. When I was originally describing him, you know, the banker, that was all I could think of was Jeff Akers. I was like, no, J-A. Yeah,
I know. I just continually just – that quiz is also super hard because there are some people where I don't know how to spell their name. And on one of them, you have to put in, like, the full name. Otherwise, it doesn't –
Mm-hmm.
Except
yeah,
it.
That's why I don't do that one because it makes me feel
I
like
actually got 100% last time I did it, so I'm just gonna
Sister,
put that out there.
You've done it too many times.
I know, it helps my memory. Okay.
Helps my memory. Okay. I'm not gonna argue with that.
But most of the time, I take a big shot in the dark for all of the Twister names because I have played Trails Twister once ever. So uh-huh. I'm like, I know that there's a Frosty. And a Scott. Yeah.
There's Frosty, Scott.
Paw.
Paw.
The chick. And.
Oh, shit.
And then
there's the sweet little dummy mechanic.
Chase and Debbie, by the way.
Chase, thank you.
And Debbie's the
one. And Debbie. I don't give a shit about Debbie. Fuck Debbie.
Yes, that's why I don't have really many favorite characters in this game mm-hmm. at all. It's because they're all nondescript, pretty much.
Yeah, that's why I don't have, yeah. So I can't, so, like, I don't like them, but I don't dislike them. Exactly.
It's really a plot-driven game instead of a character-driven
game. It is, which is, which I guess kind of balances out the games in general because, like, I like how a majority of the games are very character driven.
Yeah,
they're very, you know, interesting characters.
And
like,
there
even
are
if
very
the games
few games
suck for the character because, like, okay, you can say what you want about Medallion and its terrible plot, Shattered Medallion.
But the characters.
Okay, you look
confused. No.
But the characters are actually, like, really interesting and fun.
Yeah.
You know.
Whereas, I mean, there's a lot of games that there are a few games that balance the characters and plot really well, and I feel like one of them is actually Secret of Shadow Ranch,
mm-hmm.
and
yes.
another one I think is Shadow at Water's Edge. I think those are the two best balances of plot to character,
mm-hmm.
but I think this game just, they were like, yeah, we're going to have this awesome plot. And we're going
to
be
doing
all
this
stuff.
We need to fill it out with characters.
And then they get to the end and they're like, oh, right, characters. I wrote down two lines about this one. So that's
all right, let's just open up a book of phrases from the 1930s and 20s and we'll just throw them in.
Pretty much.
My book is on the early 20th century. Is that good enough? Yeah, just throw them all in. It's fine.
So what is our favorite moment/puzzle of this game?
I actually love them. I don't think there's okay. I don't think there's any puzzle I dislike. we'll get to that. There's no puzzle I particularly dislike.
Yeah, I think it's just a really nice puzzle game.
Yeah,
honestly,
and even just the oh my god, sorry, the record one just.
That's
came
what
to
I was just thinking. I was just thinking.
Yeah.
I was like, you have the sliding puzzle, and then you have to do all the record stuff, and you have to write all that down. All the cues and stuff.
Yeah, that's fun.
That
I like
one is
that
awesome.
A lot.
I also like doing the hobo signs.
Oh, yeah.
And,
hobo signs are fun.
Actually, the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
The mirror puzzle, the lasers, is actually, despite the fact that we have to watch that animation so many times, that's why one of our drinking game rules is every time we have to watch a repeated animation like that. This is the game that caused that. Because,
oh my god, Tim, that animation is so good. Yeah, let's make them play it, watch it over and over again. Yes, fuck yes!
Every single time we go in there to open up the fucking stairs and they're just like, yep, you have to watch this again. Because, you know, watching it 5 million times while you were doing the puzzle wasn't enough. But I also love...
But it is pretty.
And I love the first time. Ham radio stuff. With the Midsummer Night's Dream is my favorite Shakespeare play. Like,
absolutely.
Definitely.
100%.
And I still want to play Helena one day. No.
I know.
And I have to play Hermia.
I know.
Yes. Whatever. I'm too tall now to play Hermia as an adult, so.
I'm short enough.
So maybe if I'm ever in it later in life, I can. Maybe I'll be Hippolyta instead.
Yeah, right?
Okay, sorry, I got really sidetracked. I also like the pies because I love that kind of logic puzzle.
Yeah, that's fun. That's fun logic stuff. I like that a lot. Also, pie.
Also, pie.
Is nice. I do pie like is pie. Always good.
Every time I play this game, I want to then go bake pie.
Although then I get very upset at the end when
I know
they crashed the pie truck.
I'm like, are you kidding me?
All the pie everywhere.
Honestly.
But yeah, there are a lot of really good puzzles in it.
And there are puzzle like,
and then
boxes and shit.
There is Satan's mini game.
Okay, we're moving on to the least fave. Satan's mini game.
Moving on to Satan's mini game.
Mini golf.
Fuck that. Fuck everything about it. I hate it so much. What? Just so you can get for? I can't do this. I can't do this.
Oh, honestly. That is the worst part of the entire game. Well, pretty much. It's very close to being the worst part of the entire game. For Ariana, I think it's the worst part. For me, the worst part is the fucking driving.
I was trying desperately to describe why I hate Satan's minigame so much to Adam.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't really get words out. Like, he's looking at me like he's trying desperately to understand, but I'm just coming up with like random words to associate with. I was like, and it's stupid, and you have to go back and you have to do it all over again.
Yeah.
And
it's not how physics works.
You should not put it at the same angle every time and have it go differently. Yeah. That's not how it works.
That's not how it should work. Oh, I can't wait.
That's not
until...
even how game physics should work.
I can't wait until I make Andrew play this one.
Yeah, I think he's just going to get... He's not going to like this game.
It's going to be hilarious, though. He's going to have some hilarious quips.
Yes, he's going... Oh, my God. He's just going to...
It's going to be great.
Mm-mm.
It's going to be fucking... Awesome. I can't wait.
Oh god, we have talked to this person again. No.
if you guys like our it gives him a nice feeling of self-importance when you guys like the stuff that he says. Like, it amuses him that it's kind of popular that he called Emily Hillary Clinton. Right now he just refers to her as Hillary Clinton every single time he sees her.
Yes.
Which is pretty funny.
Oh, yes. Right.
Yes. Oh, I know. I'll post that as a post at some point. Because he said something really funny, and I think everyone will think it's funny. Because it's funny.
Because it's funny?
Also, the driving. I ranted when we were talking about Ransom of the Seven Ships about driving. But this one is worse. This one is worse because you have to refill your gas tank. And you have to avoid potholes and shit. Or otherwise you have to go buy a new fucking
The whole money thing in the entire game.
Because it's like, you have to drive around to get money.
You have to stop what you're doing. You have to drive around to get money to fill up your gas tank. So if you're like trying desperately to deliver that last telegram and you don't get back in time and you're out of gas and it's like, well, fuck, I wasn't gonna be out of gas. I was in the middle of my goddamn last thing. I hate it. I hate it. Flames on the side of my face.
Yeah, pretty much. And just that entire huge-ass fetch quest in the middle of the goddamn game is the absolute fucking worst. because it is literally, it's just like, oh yeah, I'll get you this if you go and get the tickets. Oh, I'll go get the tickets if you go get the kids some toys. Okay, you'll get the toys if you go catch a fish. And then it's just like, are you fucking
kidding
me?
Oh my god,
I
forgot about the fish. Yeah, I cut that part out entirely.
And it's just like, are you fucking kidding me? Are you shitting me?
You're shitting me. No, no, I'm sorry, sister whatever, sister Irish name. Like, why the nun gotta be Irish? Why does the nun gotta be Irish?
Well, I don't know, it's Illinois in the 1930s.
That explains anything. That explains nothing.
I don't know, I was trying to come up with something.
And just the fact that they try to make it all so cute by having their fucking fictional references in there. Well, I'm Rebecca, and
I was like, stop.
Stop it.
And then also they do like fucking, because it's like, at first I thought maybe it was all references to just like 1930s things, but then it's not.
But then there's Crystal, there's a Crystal Lake camp, whatever, you know, horror movie thing.
And then Little Shop of Horrors. Mm-hmm. I don't know, when did the original movie come out? I thought that was the 40s. I thought the original one came out in the 40s.
I think it might have come out in the 60s, but I think it was about the 30s.
Maybe it was.
But then all the subsequent, but then like the
all I know
musical
is it was in black
took place
and white.
In the 60s. Yeah,
white,
it was. So. We've seen it.
We've seen it. I just
don't remember.
But yes, it makes no sense to be referenced here. It makes literally no sense.
So hey, we've got a space to fill. Okay, we'll make it a nursery. A plant nursery, and we'll have it be a Little Shop. Why, sir? Why are we going to have it be a Little Shop? Because I fucking said so. That's
because I am overworked and underpaid. I threw a dart at a dartboard and it said.
Like 10 years later, it would have been Hamilton, okay? Like, what do you want from me? I have a list of references.
Pretty much. So that's our least favorite stuff. So what's our crackpot theory? What's yours, sister?
Okay.
I want to hear
it. Okay. So, here's the thing. All of the Nancy Drew games are always happening at once. So this just happens to be a universe where it's the 1930s. Like, constantly. So what happens is when we're in Nancy's room, quote unquote, you guys can't see my air quotes, but they're there. when we're in Nancy's room, we are outside of those universes. And so that's why we have this whole list of things. And so Nancy says, it's 1930, just to sort of like gear you up and be like, oh, okay, I'm going into 1930 when I step into this stupid room, which contains a stupid universe that's in the stupid 1930s.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, my theory is a multiverse theory.
Okay.
So that's 1930s Nancy Drew. She just happens to be and that also explains why there's all these weird time jumps, because we're going in between the various Nancy Drew universes.
Oh yeah, that makes sense. And then the only two games that are actually in the same universe are Stay Tuned for Danger and Ransom of the Seven Ships, obviously.
And actually, Last Train to Blue Moon Canyon and White Wolf of Icicle Creek.
Those
are
in the same universe, yeah.
And ones that Charlena Purcell, anyway. So there are ones that take place in the same universe.
Okay, so Secret of Shadow Ranch and The Last Train to Blue Moon Canyon and Icicle Creek are all in the same universe. And that's why the Hardy Boys look different in Last Train to Blue Moon Canyon than they do in Creature of Kapu Cave, because
that was my
they're
mind
different,
being blown, guys.
Different universe versions. Same with that's why Bess and George have had so many makeovers as well.
Exactly, and why their voices are different in certain ones, because it's, you know, things change universe to universe. It's all about, you know.
I love it.
Yeah, so mine is a multiverse theory.
I like it. Okay. Okay, I think that's good. So,
all right.
You guys
What's
need
your
to tell us.
Theory?
No, I no longer have one. No,
Aww.
Yours is better.
Aww.
Why don't you guys tell us your crackpot theories? Comment on our YouTube video, our SoundCloud, or our Tumblr. And
or our Twitter.
Or also our Twitter. I always forget we have a Twitter. So, yes, I am Risa.
And I'm Ariana.
And we're the Chromeister sisters, and we...
At least in this universe we are. Sorry.
And we are asking you guys to stay sleuthy.